Oh, this is cute.
这里的氛围和之前完全不一样了，看上去。
So yogurt had to leave.
二位已经等候多时了，那老规矩，还是先和大家打个招呼吧。
大伟哥好，旅行者们好，我是场景美术磊磊，
我是关卡设计师千岛。
哎，欢迎欢迎欢迎！那么今天两位同学要给我们带来什么样的新内容呢？
嗯，在热闹的海豚节之余啊，我们开放世界团队也会在3.4版本中为各位旅行者们献上虚拟的新区域千鹤沙地。
是的，今天我俩也是带着整个开放世界团队的期待和压力，给大家带来全新区域的情报和设计构思。哎嘿嘿嘿，两位同学啊，不用紧张啊，我们还是从你们最熟悉的内容开始跟大家。You
should be nervous because if anything goes left, we will flame UAs on Twitter. We will get your impact community is toxic. I'm not, y'all are, but yeah.
聊聊吧。哎，我很好奇啊，这次又会是一个什么样的区域呢？
3.4版本和3.1版本的新地区一样，属于须弥的沙漠部分，但带给旅行者的体验会有所不同。从前期设计来讲，除了基本的沙漠元素，美术还以龙卷风为锚点，让新地块整体呈现漩涡状来增强差异性。在设计新的沙漠场景时，我们围绕两个核。
Also, Happy New Year! I forgot to say that, and Happy Holiday.
新展开，第一个是紧张感。 相比于南部沙漠，由于受到中心巨大龙卷风的影响，偶尔会刮起强烈的沙尘暴，同时能见度也会由于沙暴而变得更低。随着越来越靠近沙暴中心，沙暴感就会越强，旅行者也将会遇到更加恶劣的环境。当然，这种表现类似双刃剑，我们不仅要制造出沉浸感，更要考虑旅行者们的游戏体验。 所以，制作团队也在其中进行了不断的尝试和体感迭代，最终呈现出这片全新的区域。Why
can I feel another world quest coming up to lower the severity of the sandstorm? I could just feel it. Y'all know how Inazuma was when it was so. I don't know. Was that one island, where Ito's boss was introduced, y'all remember when, or the part when they first introduced Raiden Shogun in the, what was it, the third island of Inazuma? Y'all remember the air being so thick and mist and a whole bunch of lightning that we had to complete a world quest in order for that to move? That, I feel that coming up, that. That is, I feel that coming up with this.
另外，在某些地带还会遇到蛰伏在黄沙之下的掠食者沙虫，在沙虫的活跃范围内探索时，旅行者需要时刻小心。沙虫依据声音与大地的震动寻找猎物的踪迹，是沙漠中的顶级掠食者。它操纵着风元素力，可以进入浮游状态。So
let me get this straight. Let me re-put him as that worm. Let me put the same animations and effects as the Drake, Runan Drake worm. I forgot his name. Let me put the same animations on that. Plus, let me do half of a similar stuff as the Golden Wizard, Wolf Lord as well. Combine that together and we got him. But just in a different color. Not brown. Just dark and light green. And we have
him。排出风石弹，攻击猎物，而栖身沙漠的圣骸兽也同样深藏着强大的力量。除了魔兽，人类敌人也。Charmander,
is that you?
自沙漠中潜藏的威胁，镀金旅团的新成员赤沙叙事人和叶伦舞者的加入，可能也会给旅行者们制造一些麻烦。
设计的第二个核心是历史。
Hold on, sir, before you get to the history of the Earmans, or the Aggies, as I like to call them, there's more of them. I'm world level 8. I can't even walk around freely and collect mushrooms without getting smacked by them. If it's not a fungi, if it's not a Scorpio from the Scrapes, if it's not, what is that one? A Scorpio, or if it's not an alligator trying to jump me, it's those. This is why I haven't finished farming Samaru.
旅行者们传递更多关于这片区域的历史故事。 这里的沙漠原先也是郁郁葱葱的森林，随着龙卷带来的地质变迁。
They better not just say what I think I just heard. Please, let me go back. Let me shut up. Let me go back.
叶轮舞者的加入可能也会给旅行者们制造一些麻烦。设计的第二个核心是历史。
You really think that's a good idea, even though having your world quests doesn't come with dialogue? Get it, storage, but this game is now about to be designed for PC players. The amount of gigabytes when it comes to these updates, so... Well, PC, PlayStation, and other devices don't involve in mobile. Still waiting for it to be on a Switch, but like, you really think I'm finna sit up here, read the world quests, and they have the most longest dialogue on Earth? I mean, no shade, I would like to know the history, but you...
yeah. 这里的沙漠原先也是郁郁葱葱的森林，随着龙卷带来的地质变迁，原先埋藏在地底的景观也得以重见天日。比如镶嵌在崖壁上巨大的遗迹群，充满荆棘、巨藤、尖锐山石形成的洞穴等，在大型裂谷的底部，旅行者。
How much you wanna bet I had to do a real quest in order to unlock that part as well? Why do you make us open certain things about the world quests? And they make the puzzles aggy SF. I just want to take a break from Genshin and play other games, but no, I'm in a chokehold when it comes to them.
还可以发现不少古绿洲的痕迹，而存在于地底的遗迹，实际上大部分都是旧王城居尔的遗址。随着越来越多的线索被发现。 旅行者可以逐步拼凑起这个古老遗迹中尘封已久的历史与故事。作为关卡设计师，我们还想给大家
Please let this be just mini puzzles for chess and not a world quest bars.
一个小小的建议，在体验的过程中，玩家朋友们可以先完成世界任务黄金闷香，并且接取新的世界任务比勒吉斯的 哀歌 之后。
Well,
I definitely won't be able to explore that world quest because I haven't not touched not one Samaru world quest.
还记得杰德和奔奔吗？作为黄金梦乡世界任务的后续，旅行者也将会与老朋友杰德再次展开冒险之旅。是的，在旅行者刚刚踏入新的区域时，除了远处的巨大龙卷之外，还会遇到一个沙漠游民的大型聚落。 名为塔尼特露营地，那么这里也将是这次故事开始的地方。整个故事将会围绕着寻找永恒绿洲展开。传说中，赤王为了纪念花神，在某处建造了一个永恒静止的空间。最终，旅行者与杰德能不能找到传说中的永恒绿洲？这片永恒绿洲究竟是一个什么样的地方
？I mean, guarantee if we want Google can, because
这里就先留个悬念吧。另外，在冒险的过程中，旅行者与杰德会遇到一个古老的魔瓶，随着冒险的推进，他身上的谜团也将逐步揭开，同时也会为我们讲述更多关于这个地方旧时代发生的一些故事。感觉是充满神秘感的一次旅行啊！沙漠与赤王的故事应该能够在这次旅途中进一步被发掘，或许还会有意想不到的惊喜等着我们吧。嗯。
那就等待着大家亲自来揭晓了。希望这次沙漠探秘能让大家有身临其境的沉浸感，能够在一个舒适的节奏中体验这片充满了奇迹的区域。是的。 我们也衷心期待着和各位旅行者们一起踏入下一片崭新的天地。
Wait, I was so focused on how adorable she is. I forgot to turn off captions. I have one positive thing and one negative thing to say. Of course, she's very adorable. She kind of reminds me of Pikachu with her little bunnies. The negative thing I have to say about this is y'all could have did better with the animation style. It's cute, but I would like to see a 3D, not 3D, a two-dimensional type of thing, like she was running, Naruto running through the bridge and whatnot. Why can't we have that same animation? I get it, creativity, but also can we do half of this and half of that? That's just me being nitpicky. This is cute.
大家晚上好，
晚上好。
哦，
又是一年海灯节。
I forgot. Wait, what language was that? How did you? Huh? What? Wait.What language is that? How did that happen? Is that Chinese?